So let's add our new permissions class to our user profile's view set. Load up the views.py file within the profiles API app. And before we add the permission class to our view set, we need to import it up here. So let's type from dot import permissions. Okay, and the second thing we need to import is the token authentication class that comes with the REST framework. There are multiple different ways that you can authenticate an API endpoint using the REST framework. We're going to be using the token authentication. The token authentication is the most effective way or the most popular way to authenticate with an API. It works by giving the user a temporary token that it inserts in the headers of the HTTP request. Django REST framework can then use this token to check that the user has authenticated with the system. So we're going to import the token authentication class from the REST framework authentication module. So type from REST framework.authentication import token authentication. Okay, so now come down to the bottom of the file and we're going to update our user profile view set to use our new permission class and the token authentication. Let's start by adding the token authentication. You do this by adding an authentication classes variable below the query set variable. Inside the authentication classes, we add a tuple which contains all the authentication types that are going to be used for our API. A tuple is simply a list which is immutable. Immutable is just a fancy way of saying it can't be changed after it's been set. So type authentication underscore classes equals, and then open the regular curved brackets and type token authentication. Make sure you put a comma at the end of the token authentication so Python knows that this object should be created as a tuple. Below the authentication classes, we're going to define the permission classes that are going to be applied to our user profile view set. So type permission underscore classes equals, open the bracket, permissions dot update own profile. And then make sure to end that in a comma too. The reason these are created as tuples is because you can add multiple authentication classes or multiple permission classes to a particular view set. So for example, you may want to use the token authentication that authenticates via a token and the session authentication that authenticates via a cookie that holds a session variable. In our case, we're just going to use the one token authentication. Okay, so save the file. That's how you add authentication and permission classes to a view set in Django. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.